Welcome to Washington America Show. Today's topic is going to improve your life.
Welcome to Washington America Show with international multimedia journalist, multidimensional, multifaceted artist and director of Human Rights Justice Council USA, Dr. Kashif Sohail.
Dropshipping is when a vendor fulfills orders from a third party and has them shipped directly to the customer. In other words, the vendors pass on the sales order to the supplier, who then fulfills the order. The vendor does not store its own inventory or ship items directly. Dropshipping is profitable, however, if you think that you can sell and get business just by listing products on your store and without doing much effort, then you can't get success. And once you follow the rules, then the dropshipping success rate can become higher.
The beauty of dropshipping is that there is practically no risk. Because you are investing so little money upfront, there is very little to lose. Because your business is inventory-less, there's no pressure to make sales because you don't have to bear the overhead of storage or shipping. One reason most dropshippers fail is that they are using the wrong platform to market their dropshipping stores and products. If dropshippers have found products that are already selling in high volumes on other shopping stores, then you only have to market them.
Money isn't required upfront because you do not need a store for inventory. The suppliers deliver the product to your customers on your behalf. There are many companies out there doing millions in sales a month doing dropshipping, but like any business, it takes a lot of hard work and dedication to growing it. You can essentially start a dropshipping company from nothing. It's possible to spend $0 and grow it into a multi-million dollar company organically.
To utilize it properly, you must know profitable dropshipping products and also all the techniques of marketing your store. And once you follow these rules, then the dropshipping success rate can become higher. If you want to earn a decent income by starting your side business, then dropshipping is definitely worth it. However, if you want to make lots of money in a short amount of time, then dropshipping is not worth it. For dropshipping to work successfully, you will have to invest time, money, and effort.
Dropshipping is a business model that allows you to sell and ship products you don't own and don't stock. Your suppliers, wholesalers or manufacturers, produce the goods, warehouse them, and ship them to your customers for you. The process is simple. You receive an order. You forward the order to your supplier. Your supplier fulfills the order. While dropshipping has many benefits, it also has many drawbacks.
What are the pros and cons of dropshipping? Many people start a dropshipping business because they think it'll be easy to run. No inventory, no problem, they say. The truth is, it's not easy. It comes with its own set of problems. With that said, dropshipping also solves many problems for retailers and wholesalers. Let's take a look at the pros and cons of dropshipping to see if it will solve your business problems or if it will add to them.
Pros of dropshipping. Low startup costs. It requires a lot of capital to stock a warehouse. Low cost of inventory, low order fulfillment costs. Sell and test more products with less risk.
Pros of dropshipping. It requires a lot of capital to stock a warehouse. You can eliminate the risk of going into debt to start your business by using dropshipping. Instead of purchasing an extensive inventory and hoping that it sells, you can start a dropshipping business with zero inventory and immediately start making money.
The cost of inventory is one of the highest costs you'll have if you own and warehouse stock. You may end up with obsolete inventory, forcing you to find ways to reduce your stock, or you'll end up with too little inventory, leading to stockouts and lost revenue. Dropshipping allows you to avoid these issues and focus on growing your customer base and building your brand. Order fulfillment usually requires you to the warehouse, organize, track, label, pick and pack, and ship your stock.
Dropshipping lets a third party take care of all of that. Your only job in this arrangement is to make sure they get your customer orders. Everything else will be handled by them. Without the constraints of a physical inventory and the costs associated with it, dropshipping allows you to update your inventory quickly, easily, and cheaply. If you know a product is doing well for another retailer or reseller, you can immediately offer it to your customers without waiting for it to arrive in your warehouse. Dropshipping allows you to test new items without the risk of carrying obsolete inventory. You only pay for what you sell.
Cons of dropshipping. Even though you don't carry the cost of warehousing stock, you will pay for dissatisfied customers. The manufacturers and wholesalers you do business with are responsible for managing and shipping your stock. If they screw up, the customer complains to you or buys from your competitor. If you start a dropshipping business, make sure you work with high-quality partners. Being able to offer new products.
The drawback to this perk is that you don't control your supplier's inventory. If they run out of stock, you run out of stock. This will result in longer lead times and lost customers. The hidden cost of dropshipping is the lack of bulk pricing. You will likely pay more for each item you sell as compared to paying less for a large inventory of items, leading to less profit. If you want to earn a lot of money using dropshipping, then you'll have to sell more products than you otherwise would have if you owned and warehoused them yourself.
If your supplier delivers products late, damages them, delivers the wrong items, or otherwise screws up your customer's order, the customer will take it out on you. You won't be able to maintain the personal touch that retailers who manage their own inventory can provide customers. You won't be able to quickly solve customer issues without overseeing the inventory yourself. You'll have to deal with your suppliers to solve problems for your customers.
This man in the middle way of helping your customers can lead to issues with your suppliers who may take a long time to do what you ask them to do, and with your customers, who will quickly get tired of waiting a long time for their problems to be solved. One reason many dropshippers fail is that they are using the wrong platform to market their dropshipping stores and products. If dropshippers have found products that are already selling in high volumes on other shopping stores, then you only have to market them. It's important for you to know about a tool that you can use to make dropshipping work better for you.
You can use a cloud-based inventory management software that integrates with your supplier's software so that both of you know how much inventory is in stock at any time. This helps you as a dropshipper synchronize your marketing and sales campaigns with your supplier's stock. When any of your supplier's customers make a sale, including you, it will update the amount of inventory in your supplier's warehouse automatically. If you want to minimize some of the issues with dropshipping and make it more worthwhile, then you need an inventory management system that tracks your stock levels in real time. The dropship company has the inventory in its warehouse, however, you can still make a profit as a dropshipping business, despite the thinner margins. If you want to increase your profits, you can raise your prices, at least as much as your market will bear. You can also sell more volume. There are many companies out there doing millions in sales a month doing dropshipping, but like any business, it takes a lot of hard work and dedication to growing it. There are challenges to this approach as well, but they mostly center on driving traffic to your site. It will take more time and investment to build your audience, but the trade-off here is that this channel is yours. Shopify never removes sellers from their e-commerce platform without very good reason, like repeated copyright infringement, which requires multiple filed complaints and reviews by Shopify before removal. Once you build your traffic and sales, it's all yours. If you are ready to start a business that can compete with retail giants, and do so on a limited budget, then follow the guidelines in this video. While it doesn't take a lot of startup funds to launch a dropshipping business, it will require an immense amount of hard work. The niche you select needs to be laser-focused and something you are genuinely interested in. A product range that isn't focused will be difficult to market. If you aren't passionate about the niche you select, you will be more apt to becoming discouraged, because it takes a lot of work to successfully scale a dropshipping business.
Here are some points to consider when selecting your niche. Seek attractive profits. When you are running a dropshipping business model, your focus is on marketing and customer acquisition, so the amount of work required to sell a $20 item is essentially the same as it would be to sell a $1,500 item. Select a niche with higher priced products. Low shipping costs are very important. Even though your supplier or manufacturer will handle the shipping, if the cost is too high, it will act as a customer repellent. Find something that is inexpensive to ship, as this also gives you the option of offering free shipping to your customers and absorbing that cost as a business expense in order to attract more sales.
Make sure your product appeals to impulse buyers with disposable income. When you are focused on driving traffic to your website, you want to experience the highest conversion rate possible because most visitors will never return. The products you are selling should trigger impulse buys and appeal to those with the financial ability to make a purchase on the spot. Make sure people are actively searching for your product. Use Google's Keyword Planner and Trends to check some common search terms related to your potential niche.
Create your own brand. Your dropshipping business will have more value if you can rebrand whatever it is you are selling and pass it off as your own. Look for a product or line you can white label and sell as your own brand with custom packaging and branding. Sell something that isn't readily available locally. Pick something your customer can't find down the street. That way, you become more attractive to a potential customer. Remember, you will be competing with other dropshipping operations as well as retail giants such as Walmart and Amazon.
This is where a lot of potential dropshippers go wrong because they look for a product that has little to no competition. That's a sign there isn't demand for that particular product. There are many reasons why a product might not have a lot of competition, including high shipping costs, supplier and manufacturing issues, or poor profit margins. Look for products that have competition, as it's a sign that there is a high demand and the business model is sustainable. Partnering with the wrong supplier can ruin your business, so it's important that you don't rush this step.
Please share the video, subscribe to our channel.